lower leg, lower leg.
Oh, not the upper leg.
Yeah, lower leg.
Wait,
he doesn't understand because you're letting go of the connection.
Yes,
because it's a normal thing of thinking, well, if I open the front door, they'll run away and they'll run into the canter. He has to go into the canter like this. So you have to keep him back.
You're right. I just assumed if I let maybe I need to let him go.
But you know what? There's people out there that's riding 20 years that still do that.
Keep the connection and let him go
around.
I also think that I'm not as coordinated when I'm doing things.
But I'm not even resting with you. Maybe I'm expecting too much from you. Now I'm expecting the most.
Well, you know what it is? If I start with the sitting trot and then I go to the rising trot, I'm having trouble getting back into the sitting trot.
That's normal. So I need to tell you that you told me that's the hardest time.
That's the hardest time. And so I think that's when I go, well, let me try canter, and then I let him go through these moves, and then I'll check it so I can.
Then you have to control the trot. Control the trot. Too much right leg, and you felt the hand just came out. Back for him. And there, what did you do? You went like this.
For the transition.
Yes, you went like this. Sort of sitting there.
Okay, don't you have to release at one point so that they can do the walk?
I mean, nobody's supposed to see what you're doing. No, everything happens by magic if you start.
Yep, it's all magic. Fairy dust.
Fairy dust.
Fairy dust.
You don't do a thing, and the water takes a dance. That was a much better sentence.
Good. Right now.